we mentioned all the time, we're talking about all the time, retailers, retailers. We have some buying groups as well with us today. We have United Hardware from Ireland, but not to mix with United Hardware in the States, which is a distribution and retailer. And we have John Stone, from the CEO of the companies, and we'd like to hear about you. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is John Stone, and I'm from Ireland. One of the first things that a person will ask me is, what does Ireland mean? And we have a very, very common term, and it is called, we love the crack. Crack is spelled C-R-A-I-C, and it comes from an old Irish word. And if a person comes to me, he will say, hello, John, what's the crack? And that means, hello, John, how are you? Where's the next party? And in Ireland, up to the year 2008 in the boom, Ireland had the crack. We had a party. Small builders overnight became developers. They drove around in big flashy Jeeps, sunglasses on the head, arm out the window, and they went from having no backside in their jeans to having jeans with holes in their pockets that cost 300 euros. And since 2008, Ireland has gone from boom to bust. But we are a nation of fighters, and we've always fought. Ireland was the only country in the world that Rome didn't conquer. So where are we now? In 2008, Ireland is fighting on. We still have the crack. We still have the parties. But we're now suffering from one big, massive hangover. Property prices have declined. We've gone from a high of building 70,000 houses in 2008 to a high of 7,000 houses last year. But we fight on. There is now light at the end of the tunnel in Ireland. At one stage, we couldn't even find the tunnel. But we're here now. That's a brief background to Ireland, what we are, what we do. We like the crack, we like the party. We export many, many things around the world. We export philosophers, good culture, good art, good drink, good pubs. We like our music, we like our culture, and we like our songs. Thank you very much. In some cases, I feel like David and Goliath listening to these presentations. Ireland's a population of 4 million people, but we've left a mark behind us. So let me continue on. Ireland, United Hardware, who are we? We're a buying group for independent hardware retailers and builders merchants. We have over 120 stores in Ireland. Some stores specialise in DIY, some stores specialise in builders' hardware. We have several chains of hardware stores, and we have a number of hardware symbol brands called Arrow Home and Garden and Home Value. Our market share is about 15%. The market in Ireland for DIY is about €2 billion euros. The sole purpose of United Hardware is to buy better for the customers, is to enable our retailers to compete. All our retailers are independently owned, and they have to compete against global brands and global chains. Everything possible to do with DIY, we purchase, paint, hardware, building materials, giftwares. We have a total of 5 people working for us in the buying department, not several hundred, 5 people working in United Hardware. These are some of our stores in the country. This is Bandon in South Cork, a very, very nice part of the country. If you think I speak fast, you won't understand these people from South Ireland, Bandon. This is a 20,000 square foot store sorry, 3,500 meters store to 35,000 square meters. It's branded, as you can see here, Arrow Home and Garden on the right-hand side, and Bandon Retail Centre. We co-brand the stores. Again, and just in Balbriggan in County Dublin, one of our main symbol stores again, Arrow Home and Garden in Balbriggan. Home Value Store in West of Ireland, County Clare. The next stop is New York. Our services. We are a sales and marketing and buying operation. We have a dedicated commercial buying team behind us, staffed by 4 people. Our buying strategy, we buy from all over the world. We spend possibly 3 months of our time traveling in the Far East. We are also members of Bricker Alliance, who also part of EDRA. Bricker Alliance is a buying group, again, for independent European DIY retailers. They have over 400 stores in Europe and parts of Russia. And I believe that the combined retail sales of Bricker Alliance is in excess of 2 billion euros. We challenge our buying team each month to have an FMTV. FMTV means FME, that's value. You can make up your own mind what the F stands for. We have our own source product, and we have local suppliers for our business. We buy directly from European manufacturers and also from international suppliers, mainly based in the Far East and China. We are again to the forefront in Ireland of developing our own brands to compete against the big brands. These are our own simple brands here, Home Collection and Garden Collection. We buy from Turkey. We buy from Israel. Keter would be a big supplier to our company, a very well-known international brand and a good company to deal with. Our brand architecture, again, this is the way that we want to compete and gain competitive advantage through the value of own brands, buying directly and competing and winning business for our retailers. This is our warehouse and office, quite salubrious. Again, it was built in the good times. We had it now with different operation, but again, there's light at the end of the tunnel for us. We found a way, thanks to Angela Merkel. Marketing support. We just don't buy product, we sell a product and we market our business. We help our customers to gain extra business. How do we do this? Well, we have our own propaganda. Our propaganda includes leaflets, flyers, our online presence, meeting customers on a daily basis. So this is a selection of some of our propaganda that we distribute to the marketplace. Our flyers, which is a key driver for our business. We are the first independent group in Ireland to develop a full transactional online site. That was 10 years ago. Still a small proportion of our sales, but as you know very well, it's only going one way at the moment. Again, some point of sale here, whether with advertising or leaflets. Everybody's doing the same. We're trying to do something different by working different ways, predominantly when it comes to online presence. So we publish posters, newsletters, radio and TV, online sales, omnichannel, the whole shebang. Our store development, we sit down with our retailers and we develop new concepts, new formats based on category management. Again, we travel the world. We are part of Ace Hardware, a superb American company. And I think you will agree that the Americans are superb at how they market their business. And we learned so much from dealing with Ace Hardware. And we learned so much so far also in dealing with Bricker Alliance and with Hedra since we joined both those organizations. 3D store plans. We have a full-time CAD office in Dublin and we help stores with some of our of our 3D layouts for them. We tell them where the till will go, the customer flow in the shop, where the hot points are, where the power aisles will go in the store itself. Full IT and admin development. We operate a central billing system. Central billing was good in the good days. That means that we pay the supplier and we in turn then invoice the stores. Happy days during the boom. Big hangover in the recession. Because under central billing, United Hardware happily paid the suppliers. And then we chased the stores for the money. And of course, the builders, who are now developers, had no backside in the trousers, and the banks closed the business down. The builders subcontracted out all of the work to plasterers, carpenters, electricians. The banks wouldn't pay the developers. The developers wouldn't pay the builders. The builders wouldn't pay the subcontractors. And our business very nearly closed down overnight. But it didn't. We are the Fighting Irish, and we fought, and we continue to fight. That's all I have to say to you. I look forward to seeing the suppliers this afternoon. Thank you very much, Ireland.